What's up, baby girl?
Hey, Steven.
Not the voice. Don't do it. Is this really your normal talking voice?
It's 4 a.m. and I live with my family. Yeah, that's my normal voice now.
How's college coming along?
Pretty good. Graduated about, 7 days ago.
Wow, what'd you get your degree in?
Oh, it's just an associate's right now. I'll be transferring, but it's in sociology.
Wow. What's your, how old are you again? I forgot. I'm sorry, fuck.
I'm 21.
Gotcha. Okay.
One second.
Shut down. Let's settle the score. An ally has been
slain. I'm thinking perhaps I should go outside.
Oh man, that's disgusting. You have a wireless headset?
Hmm? Oh no, I have a phone.
Wait, am I talking to you on a phone? Oh, like phone Skype.
And I'm naked, of course, so let me get a robe on.
You have robes? What? What the fuck?
There we go. You don't have a bathrobe?
No.
Then what do you do after your bath?
Walk around in a towel?
An enemy has been slain. What about your arms?
They're naked?
Oh. Okay.
Do you have like, are you like really self-conscious about like your upper body or whatever?
I really like my upper body, Steven.
Well then why do you cover it up with a robe?
Cause it's comfy, Steven.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Fuck, what was, oh my god, I'm 4 a.m. I'm making bad choices every second I stay up. Yeah, no, you're completely right. In the DSM, the dysphoria that you feel, when your brain and your body don't sync up, that's
like the disorder part, yeah.
Yeah, that totally is. It causes harm to the individual. They aren't recommending that people stop undergoing hormone therapy. The reason why suicide rates remain consistent is that pre-transition, transgender people commit suicide over the dysphoria between their mind body, and after transition they commit suicide because they're ostracized from their family.
Well, that's kind of conjecture. I don't know if like you're qualified. I don't think the study that I read actually said that. Of course, also like there are a lot of reasons why people post do it, but yeah. But yeah, that's like, there's like a big problem with, I mean, I agree. I would agree with that. Like, if I read that, it wouldn't be surprising at all that people kill themselves because of, you know, inability to,
connect with their peers.
With everything. It's more than just that. Peers, work life, relationship life, family.
A lot of people, I think, don't care about transgender issues because it's such an abstract problem. And most of the transgender people we meet, we don't know they're transgender because it's actually, you can pass pretty well.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with that, but...
I know 4 or 5 transgender people, and 3 to 4 of them had to tell me. Maybe I'm non-perceptive, but
okay.
There's a lot of people out there. They do a good job. I mean, it's something over which they're very self-conscious. They have to do a good job.
Okay.
But,
I think that... I don't know if it's a lot of money or what, but I do know that there are a lot of problems with some people feeling okay about their reassignment because even after surgery, it might not feel normal. I'm basing this on very few examples. Did you see the ex-Riot employee that killed herself?
I did.
You read, like, her note and everything? I think one of the reasons, looking at pictures of her and everything, like, it seemed like she was really unhappy with the end result and everything, not to mention the problems with work life and family and everything afterwards. Although it sounded like her family and everybody supported her, because she seemed, I guess, as cheery as you could be in her suicide note.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, people forget that transgender people are probably the most dumped on group in contemporary American society. They have the highest suicide rate, they have the least, like, people understand them the least, so it's incredibly shitty at them, and there's like 1,000 obstacles in their way. And for once, I'm actually conceding that bigotry is not necessarily the biggest issue. That's stupid. It's the biggest issue. But it's just complicated. I mean, it's because they're born in the wrong body. Fixing that isn't easy. I think that pre-puberty surgery, like you mentioned this earlier, I think that's just the way to go.
But that's so hard, dude. Like, you're closer to the age than I was. Like, I don't know if I would trust...
I'm not that much younger than you.
Wow, 5 years younger, aren't you? You said you're 21?
Holy shit, you're 26.
I am, yeah. But I mean, I remember being a teenager. I don't know if I would trust a teenager to make the decision that they were the wrong gender, you know?
Again, I'm not a psychologist or physiologist, so my opinions on the medical side of transgender issues are just entirely researched opinions. I have no credentials, but
yeah, sure.
from what I understand...
I think I know what you're going to say. I've heard similar things.
What do you think I'm going to say?
I've read that some people say that feeling transgendered isn't just like an emotional thing. It's something where, like, if you'll know it at an early age, and it's not just something you'll think you're going through a phase about, right? Something like that.
I've talked to a lot of trans people and read a lot of trans people's thoughts online, and it did seem like every single one of them knew when they were young. Knew on some base level, some instinctual level. I mean, it's really down to math, right? If there was some sort of peer counseling service for young people, where if a child suspects they may be transgender, they could speak with the counselor and get a sort of official medical diagnosis. With some trials, it's entirely possible it could prevent more harm than it would cause by, say, false positives.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, that would be, like, the thing. Is if it could, like, actually reliably be figured out to where you could identify it pre-puberty and make it like really reliable, and then you'd have to ask yourself what an acceptable error rate would be, you know?
Yeah. Oh yeah. No. There's no 100 clean cut solution to any of this. It's not like homophobia or racism where you can just kill all the bigots and then the world is perfect. It's medical science going advanced so quickly, and the same with behavioral science. I'm happy to hear, by the way, that discussions of trans people are now rather rampant on the internet. They used to be an invisible minority.
Yeah, but I know we disagree a lot on this, but I do think that those issues get hijacked by some really fucking crazy people sometimes, which makes it out to be a lot worse. And I feel like with the right explanation, I feel like pretty much anybody should be able to see, like, okay, well, you know, trans people are really fucked, which they are, more so than probably any other disparaged group at the moment that I can think of. And, you know, like, we need to do some shit to, you know, kind of help them out and be bros, you know? But the way that it comes across so much, like, there's so much stupid shit, and I feel like the athletic thing is, like, one of those things. I feel like if I had the opportunity to talk to somebody about an issue like this, like, I could make them see that, like, hey, like, being transgendered is really fucking shitty. Because there are a lot of people, there are still, and this might blow your mind, but I have a very conservative mother, there are a lot of people that think that transgendered people just choose to be a different gender. They're like, oh, they just want to be a guy. Like, oh, they're just choosing to be transgender. Which,
Steven,
if you're not fucking retarded, like, you know, it's the stupidest fucking thing in the universe,
Steven.
Right? What?
Word choice. But, yeah, no. Remember when you once told me you probably read shit Reddit says more often than I do, and I probably read men's rights more often than you do?
Yeah, sure.
I know plenty about what conservative people think of trans people. And it's pretty disgusting. Yeah, no, they get dealt a shitty hand. It's not, their problems aren't entirely social. But we have to remember that much like people learning to love their bodies or people's acceptance of, say, AAVE, like African American dialect, a lot of what some
Does that mean, are you talking about Ebonics? Is that your word for it?
That's most certainly not the word used in common academic discourse, but what? Yeah, same thing.
I think that's really, I actually horribly disagree with that, but okay.
I think that
educated black men would be really offended if you were to call Ebonics or illiterate speaking from hipster black youth, they would be really offended to hear you call that African American dialect, if that's what you're referring to.
It's a cultural dialect. It's not inherently inferior or superior to
my
way of speaking English or British's way of speaking English or anything. This is, you've talked with linguistics on this. Modern linguistics agree that there is no prescriptivist way of describing language. All languages on Earth are more or less equal in their capacity of conveying thought and emotion. There's no difference. It's just what we're accustomed to. I can't speak in AAVE. I live in fucking Beverly Hills. Do you think? No, I'm stuffy as shit. But they're both equal. I mean, they both work.
I can't really have this kind of, I would have to find an educated black man, but I know for a fact that there would be, like, educated black people that would be, like, really, really, really offended by you calling Ebonics from uneducated people, would be really offended you calling that black speak. That's essentially what you're doing.
I did not. It's a cultural dialect. It's not black speak. Black people can speak any dialect language.
Yeah, but you're calling it African-American dialect.
I think it's African American Vernacular English. I think that's the actual, the term. But I don't actually care what educated black men have to say. these things aren't just subject to conjecture. There's actual academic discourse on it. I mean, obviously. And
what's wrong with just calling it Ebonics?
Because I don't know. It's not currently the PC language. There's probably a good reason. I don't know it. It's just, it didn't take me any effort to change which words I use.
Okay.
But I, again, same basic point. But at any rate, what I was trying to say about transgender people is that we have to remember that what we consider certain demographics to be and their hierarchy in society, it's as prescriptive as it is descriptive. Maybe transgender people wouldn't be so dissatisfied with how many of them feel post-transition if we weren't so insistent on the binary between masculine and feminine traits, you know?
Yeah, obviously, yeah.
Right, so what I'm saying is that if transphobes just fucking died, then it'd be fine. That was the general.
Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, nobody disagrees with that. That's like saying if all racists died, that would be good too, I mean. But I mean, obviously the world doesn't work in such a way.
No. And I actually would not advocate that, I mean. I was racist when I was 13. I turned out okay by my standards. But yeah, no, at any rate, I'm very happy to see that this is a topic that interests you to some degree. Better to be a contested minority than an invisible minority, wouldn't you say?
I mean, I don't agree with you calling it a contested minority. I think I'm pretty good on trans issues just because I disagree about this specific thing. But...
No, I mean contested like in society.
Contested.
Yeah. I don't think society's reached clear consensus on whether or not they're going to grow the fuck up and learn to accept that trans people are, you know, equal to us. On some spiritual level. At any rate, Stephen, earlier you said, you said that these issues have been pushed to the wayside by extremists who have different motives.
Not pushed to the wayside, but delegitimized. If you're advocating for a bunch of things, so I don't know if you've noticed this in an argument, some people will do this in an argument, where you talk about a bunch of things, you bring up like 6 or 7 points, and you're wrong on one of them, and then they hammer that one point until it feels like you've lost the entire argument, even though you were correct on like everything except for that one thing. Are you kind of aware of that, what I'm talking about?
I've argued with your chat, what do you think?
Sure.
Yeah, no, it's fucking obnoxious. That too, but I don't think that's like a Tumblr or lay feminazi thing. I think that's just poor internet arguing ethics 101, isn't it?
Fuck, sorry, hold on. I feel like we're gonna lose this game.
Make the plays or feed, you can do your thing. I'm up at 4 a.m., I'm not going anywhere.
Team is so worthless. How? 280. Are we gonna lose here?
Well, obviously you fed bot lane early on.
No, I don't think so. Leona's like better. What?
Your inhibitor has been destroyed. It's a beautiful night out tonight.
Jace, you have 9 deaths. What are you fucking talking about? Sorry. So the problem is that, I like to compare it a lot to being pro-life, okay? I'm a very pro-life person, right? But for, I say rational reasons, but I mean, obviously you can disagree with my rationale, right? But what I mean is I'm not pro-life for religious reasons, right? I don't believe in any of that shit. And I don't call people that, like, are pro-choice. I don't call those people, or pro-abortion, whatever. I don't call those people, like, murderers or anything, right? But I happen to be anti-abortion, right? But it sucks in my position when I'm anti-abortion, and then when I see people argue against abortion, I see like a bunch of like really crazy, stupid shit. Like people will say things like, "Oh, well, you could be aborting the next Beethoven," or like stupid
that.
And it's like, okay, well, fuck. Like, no. Like, I'm an anti-abortion, but I'm not like a total idiot, right? So like sometimes when I see people talking about certain trans issues, right, and it's like transgender people are treated like shit. Like everybody needs to be nice to transgender people. Like, yeah, for sure, transgender people deserve equal representation in sports. If you're trans, you should still be able to go into whatever sport you feel you identify with. No, I don't think so at all. Not even close. I think that's like crazy fucked up, actually. And
well,
then people focus on stuff like that. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Like, there's only been, like, one definitive ruling on the subject, and from a person who's an expert in their field, they seem to feel like, after a short period of time, there is no advantage.
We can look at that. There's no point in arguing
but
that we should look
Steven,
at
it. Steven, please be honest with me. Is this something that you're arguing because it seems like common sense that transgender women would have an advantage, or do you have some backing in this field that makes this opinion stronger than just hearsay?
I mean, this isn't hearsay at all. It's like, it's very real that, Jesus, she's so strong. It's very real that men are stronger than women and have a lot of athletic advantages over women. Like, physiologically, you know that's true, right?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
Steven.
Well, I don't know, because you're asking me if it was just my opinion that men are stronger than women. That's not just like a sexist thought or whatever.
No.
It's like a very real thing.
Transgender women aren't men, Steven. They're people who have been subjected to extensive hormonal therapy.
Well,
that has removed.
First of all, there's varying degrees of post-op. You understand that, right? Some people
they
have...
They said 2 years was a reasonable
2 years of hormone replacement therapy, sure. I really don't think that there's enough medical evidence right now that there are any peer-reviewed studies that say that 2 years after post-operative hormone replacement that somebody will be physiologically identical in terms of like athletic prowess to like a man or a woman after transition. I don't think that's true. So the fact that I don't know.
I mean, they did. I mean, look.
Well, okay. they. You keep saying they, but it was just that one person that I read, and that
but
one person.
Just one person, Steven. What? And one of you plays video games for a living. No offense, I would too.
I'm not. This isn't my claim. This is like decades and centuries of medical science saying that men are stronger than women. That's the position that I take.
But we're not talking about. Okay, look. I think here's the only thing I can say about it because I'm not a medical professional, and my opinion is actually equal to yours in this matter. I personally, from what I've experienced, what I've seen, I mean, I've seen transition photos of men who looked like three knees stacked wide, turning into just these slim, just insanely massive body changes.
Okay,
in my opinion, I believe that transgender women after a certain period of hormone therapy would equal a physical state that is comparable to that of top female athletes. How much time would have to pass for that to occur? I don't know. But speaking as a radical feminist, trans rights activist, I can say definitively that I agree with you. Men are generally stronger than women, and yes, a period of time of hormone taking would be necessary before it'd be a fair fight. Not disputed. We can agree on that, right?
Sure. I want to read more on it. I have to finish this game. I haven't read enough on this. But I know that if a study like that would have been passed where a medical consensus was reached about it, I know I would have read it. Come on, dog. You really? Is our jungler dead? I think he is.
I mean, researchers have barely acknowledged the existence of transgender people. I mean,
yeah, but unfortunately, as sad as that is, that just strengthens my argument that there hasn't been good research on it.
Well, that's not an argument in your favor. That's an argument in favor of no ruling. That's
exactly. Neutral. But the default is that.
For you, the default is. Have you ever met a female athlete? When I was in fucking 11th grade, I took on a female athlete in my wrestling class. I'm 6'2", 200 pounds.
You're not athletic, though. It doesn't matter but you're not athletic, so this doesn't matter.
This is completely anecdotal and it doesn't matter.
Yeah, so, no, like, it matters so little that you shouldn't even be bringing it up. If you're not athletic, I mean, I'm sure I could find, I know, I saw a fucking black chick that goes into the gym and fucking warms up with my fucking squat max before. Like, I know that there are strong women out there, but compared to strong male athletes, like, it's not a fair comparison at all. There's reasons why there's different divisions.
I had a crush on her. I just wanted to reminisce. Man.
Okay,
my wrestling.
My bad. Yeah,
yeah dude. She flipped me.
Sure.
Over her back. So cool. No, but seriously, no. Yes, men stronger than women. I know. I've been a man for 21 years. I get, like, I know they're smaller generally.
No. It's not just smaller. It's things like people bring up. It's things like. Okay. Like things like bone density and things like a whole bunch of fucking hormonal shit and physiological shit and fucking ability to build muscle and fucking CNS adaptations and all. There's like all sorts of shit. There's like a significant difference between a man and a woman. I'm not saying this to like justify like sexist attitude or whatever, but just in terms of like physical prowess, it's like a very important thing, right?
Look, I've never heard of a feminist actually arguing against the concept that men are generally speaking stronger than women.
Okay, all right.
Because I mean that's stupid. You'd have to be stupid.
You know, some people, including the SRS Empire right now, thinks that words like stupid and idiot are ableist. I just thought I would update your vocabulary.
Thank you, Stephen. I'm familiar. with the SRS. You know how inactive SRS has been over the past 6 months or so?
Oh, they've been about as active as ever.
No. Back 2 years ago, they were a powerful force on Reddit.
I think it depends. I guess with like the light in light of like all the Gawker shit and everything, and like putting that one guy. I guess maybe, I don't know.
I blame Gamergate, because now it's like a Gamer Gazi that's taken front center for like the front line of active pro social justice people on Reddit, and now SRS is kind of like an archaic subreddit. I don't even know what I'm looking at when I go there anymore.
Well, I mean, it's just people pointing out what they perceive to be social injustice on Reddit and then making fun of it. Isn't that what they've always done?
Yeah, thank you, Steven.
Wait, I mean, that's what they want. What do you want me to say?
Thanks for clearing that up.
No problem, Bob.
How? Okay, look, it was 3 a.m., I masturbated, I went to bed, and I was like, oh shit, that's Steven. And then the moment I get on, people are talking. You're talking about trans stuff. Is this like a common sticking point with your stream now?
No, I don't remember. Oh, somebody just liked that news story about the woman, so we started talking about it, I guess.
Who?
The fox, right?
The boxer?
Yeah.
The lady. Yeah, what about her?
Yeah, people were talking about that story or something, or I saw it on Facebook. I don't remember. I saw it somewhere, and we started talking about it.
Yeah, it was an interesting story. I mean, I remember following it. The feminist section of Reddit cheered when that decision was made, because it was this firm anecdotal argument against the idea that transgender women are somehow permanently unlike cisgender women. I mean, athlete's gonna athlete, yo.
I don't agree. Athlete's
gonna athlete?
No.
That's tautological. Do you wanna start an argument against that?
Well, I mean, you're trying to say that all athletes are the same, which is
no,
a false equivalence.
Okay, Steven,
so.
I'm just saying there's a difference between men and transgender women. They don't even have the same name. They aren't the same gender.
I don't want to talk about this until I can like get out of my game and like look up. Because I want to read more about it, because I'm not qual. I can't. I haven't read enough to like actually say anything. So.
Okay, like, just so you know, because this I do know. Okay, you do know the difference between gender and sex, right?
Yeah, depending on who you talk to, sure.
There's only one difference. It's factual.
I don't know if it's medically accepted yet or if it's still just like a psychology thing. But yeah, I know the difference. The idea that sex is your genitals and gender is what you identify as.
Well, yeah, gender is a collection of societal norms and values that you adopt as a persona, and
You're putting a lot of weight into that. I don't think that's necessarily true. When you say something like that, you kind of devalue what a transgender is. You realize that, right?
Wait, what?
You're saying that a transgender person only feels like they're the wrong gender because of societal expectations and whatnot. You realize when you say that?
Oh, no, because transgender people are actually, there's a sexual difference. Their chemistry is different. Transgender is kind of a misnomer, but so is transsexual, I believe. Even in a world without gender, transgender people are still different because it's a physical
difference. Wait, so you think transgender people are the right sex and the wrong, or what?
Their brain chemistry and their body chemistry is different. There's a chromosomal mismatch between the chemistry of their brain and the chemistry of their body. Whether you can argue that the brain's right, the body's wrong, or the body's right and the brain's wrong, but at the end you can't change a brain, not in that way. But you can change a body to a significant degree. That's why hormone therapy goes the route it does, because there's no way to make a brain's chromosomal makeup match the way the body.
Chromosome, I don't think it's the right word there.
Well, the
brain chemistry. I gotcha.
Yeah. So, no. But yeah, I mean, I'm a radical feminist. I don't believe in gender. I think it's an archaic social construct. I look forward to a future where.
Yeah, but when you say something like that, then if a transgender person is like, hey, I feel like I'm transgender, then that means that your response to them would be like, oh, no, you're not transgender. You just have a wrong idea about what gender is, right? No?
Well, no, because I think that even in a genderless world, there still would be chemistry different. I'm gesturing frantically at, like, my head to my legs right now. You can't see it. It's really frantic. There would still be a difference in the brain chemistry and the body chemistry.
But you're saying that gender is just a social construct, so how could a transgender actually feel like they're the wrong gender unless they're just reinforcing social construct?
Well, okay, for the purposes of this discussion, don't use the word transgender. Use the word fuck, wrong body, bad Lego.
Okay, but the only reason why their body feels quote-unquote wrong is because you're saying that they just believe in a gender construct that they shouldn't believe in, or a social construct.
It's chemical. Their dysphoria is caused by
a chemical. So then you're saying that there is some kind of chemical definition of gender.
No, sex.
You're saying that, okay.
There's a chemical difference between sex. Males and females of the hue. Oh my god, that sounded like such a fedora.
I don't think there's anything wrong with saying males and females. I know, like, the fempire is, like, really against it, but I don't think it's necessarily bad to say those things.
It's just when people say men and females. It's just really weird. Oh. Like, no one ever says women and males. No one fucking says that. It's just
I think that's because saying women is really weird. I feel like you
what?
Can... Well, it's like, this is a social thing, but I feel like you can get away with calling a lot of people men, and it's, like, a compliment. Whereas with, like, women, it's kind of weird because you don't know if you're calling them old or, like, am I really a woman? Why not a lady? Like, I think that sounds really dumb, but...
Well, no, I think that's completely fair. Because that's part of the social dichotomy. Because women are discriminated against. That's the reason why. There are less, like, the same ways that gender is an unambiguously positive term to call a man, but lady is used in a variety of derogatory or casual ways. There's a lack of clear... dictionary, like, terms to refer to women, and it can get confusing and mismatchy because a lot of them have been degraded over time. Lady, when you say, like, come on, man, it's like, whatever, that's almost gender neutral. But when you say, come on, woman, like, you know what I mean?
Wait, what?
A different.
I'm sorry, I was supposed to.
Different connotation. When you say something like, come on, woman, or women.
I did no damage in team fights. Holy shit. Wait, okay, what?
Okay, I agree with you in that there are not enough words to refer to women in the English language because we have a billion with men that have a variety of different uses and not so many with women.
Oh, yeah,
at
sure.
At the same time, what's wrong with saying women? Like, my mom is a woman.
Oh, yeah, no, I just think this is something that, like, I don't agree with, like, making fun of people for it. I think that you can be a very, like, progressive person with a lot of good thoughts and not be gender sexist or anything at all, and you can still say something like, oh, like, men and females or whatever, and like, it just comes out, but it's I'm just saying, I don't know. I feel like people make fun of, like, a lot of, like, really weird things. I understand that that's kind of, like, a shitty one, but, like, the whole, like, female, it's like, well, I don't think anybody was saying it because they, like, hate women so much that they can't even call them women, they have to call them female, experiment.
Some people do.
Yeah, sure, some people do, but not everybody. And when you kind of paint a broad brush over everybody, you kind of just hurt your own position, I think, when you're trying
to
take
the moral
high.
Everyone paints with a broad brush.
Yeah, I know, but, like, I don't know. I wish people were...
Look, I'm beyond the days where I think the feminist movement is some enlightened, above them all, kind of, like, we have the best man. Everyone is stupid, including you and me. It's like, especially you and me. It's just what was I going to say? You know, it's just fun making fun of certain characteristics. The same reason why neckbeard. Why is your chat so fucking fond of autism as an insult?
We've moved on from faggot.
We don't say that word anymore.
Wow, it's
great fucking step up. But if you're in a pool of shit and you step one ring up, you're still mostly in shit.
Yeah, hey, man, one step at a time, dog.
I look forward to checking in 3 years.
I use autism less. We moved on to kill yourself. I don't know what we're going to go through after kill yourself. Who knows, man? From insult to insult. Till someday we'll arrive at something where everybody double plus bad.
What happened to pleb? That's just so everyone uses pleb. My mom says pleb.
Okay.
That was a lie. She has no idea about that word. Whatever. Anyway, yeah, no. It's like, it's just fun. Like, fucking, I'm like, everyone makes fun of the atheists or enlightened religion, fucking religious people or just illogical. But I still say fedoric things from time to time. It's just everyone engages in that behavior from time to time.
Sure.
You say fedoric things, don't you?
All the time, mate. I'm an enlightened individual. Why would I not?
Yeah, it's fedoric.
Oh, physiological differences between male and female. Oh,
yeah,
this
I can't see
some...
chat. Is chat calling from my head? I'm on my phone.
Yeah, always.
Okay, it's just making sure. Yes, the physiological differences between males and females. Is that what I'm saying? Yeah, no.
Yeah, but that's not relevant to what we're reading about. We want transgendered woman versus man athletics.
But what there was a point back there. Yeah, no, with sex, there's a... hold on a moment. All right, hello?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, okay. No, the big... It's a bit of a misnomer using the term transgender. Kind of. I don't know. I'm not a linguistics expert. Because the dysphoria that's referred to is a sexual difference between the way the brain and the body makeup exists. Gender is a complete social construct. The only difference is that if a person... if there's a transgender woman, like they're born male physiologically... at least in their body.
I know everything. I think everybody actually knows everything you're talking about. We're just like making it really confusing by using a ton of different words that we've like redefined.
You autistic faggot.
Those words have a pretty consistent definition for a
long
time.
How long do you think gender has meant just the gender you personally identify as?
As long as I've been a feminist.
Okay, so these are relatively new things. I mean, but I'm just saying that, like, this conversation is literally like a waste of time because we all know the concepts. It's just like
all
we're getting
conversations are a waste of time, Stephen.
Why
you
do
might
you say
as well
that?
Talk...
What? That's not
when
true.
Was the last time you learned anything from an internet argument?
All the fucking time. I've had tons of fucking arguments recently. I've learned all sorts of shit. Here you go. Like, I got into an argument with a guy the other day about the minimum wage. Hold on, let me find. Look at all this fucking.
Oh my god, I forgot you're a libertarian.
No, actually, I'm not. Actually, I'm completely the opposite. I'm almost borderline socialist now. You have no idea how much I've changed over the past 3 years. But yeah, look at all this shit. I learned all sorts of stuff. I think arguments
only
are
good. Only borderland? You fucking bourgeois scum.
Wow.
Yeah, wait, no, continue. I'm actually interested.
Well, no. Some say conversations are good. Yeah, if you talk with people you disagree with, then you're forced to reevaluate your point of view, or... What, you either, there are either one of two things happens when you argue with somebody, if you're an intelligent person, right? You either reinforce your point of view by doing more research that confirms what you believe, or you change your point of view to something better because it's good enough to make you change your point of view, right? So I think conversations are good.
I don't argue with people that much anymore because I feel like everyone, like, okay, you know, like, with the fat people hate explosion that's been happening on Reddit?
Yeah.
You have to know. Yeah, okay. And, like, the gamer game. Like, there's been no actual discourse. It's just been screaming. And in college,
well, but that's because a lot of people don't even know, like, there's and this is another part that I hate about, like, SRS and SRS type mindfit and the Gamergate thing especially. The Gamergate thing was really disgusting.
Irishladdie is literally a faggot.
Which part?
All of it. But unfortunately, mainly the anti-Gamergating was the most disgusting part. Because, sorry, dog, but it was.
Can't we just get along?
The problem is when you start to relabel what your opponents are talking about into some, like, crazy strawman shit that nobody believes in, I feel like you just heard everything. Nothing gets done. There's no valuable conversation
anymore. I mean, like, what is there to be said about it? Gamergate is a harassment movement that was created
that's
by
not true. Nah, come on,
dog.
Come on. Nah, that's not entirely true. There were a lot of people in Gamergate. So this is factual. Whether or not you want to accept it.
I'm about to have a Gamergate argument at 4:30 a.m.
I really don't give a fuck about Gamergate, so I have no strong opinions on it one way or another. However, you have to consider. And if you don't, then you're delusional and you shouldn't be having these discussions. You have to concede that there were a lot of people involved in Gamergate that legitimately wanted to see less bullshit happen in gaming journalism. You do acknowledge that there is a lot of bullshit kind of camaraderie shit that goes on in gaming journalism, right? You know that happens, right? Women or men.
Okay, do you want a yes-no answer or do you want an agenda?
Just a yes-no. Just a yes-no answer. Yeah, you know that, right?
Are you a judge? Can you smack the gable with if I continue? Hold up. Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
I agree. At the same time...
There was there bad shit going on?
That's like being a men's rights advocate because you think that divorce courts are like paternal. Like,
okay, no. But then you went into weird understandings here. Remember how mad everybody gets when you're like, don't call it feminism because that's been ruined. Call it egalitarianism. And then everybody's like, dog, the people that go around and do horrible things under the guise of feminism, those aren't real feminists. You can't tell all feminists call themselves egalitarianists just because some feminists think you ruined it or whatever, right?
Right now, everyone who calls themselves egalitarian should be shot against the back.
Okay, so but don't you think that's kind of unfair that there are a lot of people involved in Gamergate that legitimately want to see things changed in gaming journalism, but for some reason, because of a few anonymous trolls on Twitter that decide, and then for people that have jumped in because they do hate women, now all of Gamergaters are women-hating people? Like, I don't know. I don't like that. I don't think it's fair.
Okay, look, every movement is going to have some kernel of... Okay, that's completely fucking wrong, because neo-Nazism is a thing. Most movements that are dominated by shitty people are going to have kernels of legitimate, like, interest in them that I can back up personally.
I don't think we're ever going to agree on this.
Men are disadvantaged in some ways in societies. In that way, I would agree on several points with men's rightsers. However, outside the yoke is not enough. Because it's like the core of a planet. I'm not living on the core, and neither is anyone else. You live on the surface. Everything that gets upvoted, like mass upvoted in Kotaku in action, is bullshit about feminist censorship. Like, grade A, pureed, 100%.
Yeah, but the problem is both sides of both...
If they wanted to change the gaming, which I do. I play video games a lot, Steven. I'm not some. I like and I hate the modern game. It's like, fuck. If they wanted to, then why don't they show support for some of the actual?
But they do. You can't say that. And unfortunately,
like Kotaku,
no. First of all, Kotaku is like really iffy.
They have a lot of articles on like really shitty journalism from other groups.
Unfortunately, I'm not invested in it. First of all, I have to stop you and correct you, because even 4chan supported like an indie dev or whatever working on, as much as you hate them, even 4chan did. So you can't necessarily say that.
Wait, which indie dev?
I don't know. When they made, like, 4chan made, like, that fucking girl character, and somebody started, like, designing a game, and they used that shit in
art. Everyone likes indie devs. I mean, fuck. Everyone.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying that, like, even fucking 4chan has gotten behind, like, devs that they support and shit before, regardless of that. But the problem is, like, Gamergate, I think, perfectly encapsulates everything that's wrong with humanity, because both sides just started arguing against other things that nobody believes or supports. Like...
Why is everything that's mass upvoted on Kotaku in action about feminist censorship bullshit?
Because those are... Why is everything that's on SRS upvoted about how every single man is a rapist and a pedophile on Reddit?
Okay, you know for a fact that that's satire and one action.
No! You can't hide behind that! You don't know what satire is if that's what you think... When George Carlin gets up and gives like a a comedic routine about how like America like fucks up all these things or like the Illuminati and shit, you can't just go, oh well, George Carlin is just doing satire, like he doesn't mean any of that. That's not true at all. George Carlin means a lot of that.
Okay, then let's acknowledge the difference between this then. Okay, and the difference between SRS and Kotaku in action, if that's where we're drawing the line. SRS is a sub that is literally self-referential as a circle jerk, wherein every single fucking poster that contributes there regularly has said elsewhere, in no uncertain terms, that there is a persona that goes into that, that it is a hyperbole, an exaggeration of the caricature other people paint of feminists. That's the joke.
Whereas
action is the flag subreddit for an actual self.
Have you ever heard of the No True Scotsman fallacy? Because you're doing it so hard right now. Like, it's painful. You are. Because what you're saying is, okay, well, my opponents at, say, Kotaku in action, these guys are all as horrible as they appear on their subreddit, and they are all horrible, horrible people who do these horrible things. Oh, SRS is acting crazy hyperbolic? Oh, no. Well, no. Real feminists aren't actually like that. These guys are all just doing, like, satire. Like, that's like a crazy No True Scotsman thing. Like, this sounds
it is. Steven.
It exactly is.
SRS, it refers to itself as satire. They explicitly say not to take the poster seriously. Do you see
that's not true.
There are people who...
No. That's not true. It's not satirical. It's just a circle jerk. There's a difference. Yep.
Okay,
much
Steven,
the same way
please,
that, like...
Please answer this. Yes, no. Do you actually believe that people in SRS really think, like, all men are rapists, all men should die?
I mean, I don't know. It's hard to say.
Steven, please. Do you honestly... There's, like, the Scum Manifesto, which was this super hyper-radical, like, 1990 or 1980s, whatever...
So are you saying that when SRS started emailing lists of my sponsors saying that I was a pedophile, even though they had misrepresented and misheard everything, you think that was all just like a big like satire troll? And when they did the same thing to In Control, that was all just them being satirical?
Steven, aren't I one of the people who was sending emails?
So were you just being satirical then? Or
no, I believe that was
okay, so so
now, I did not support any allegations calling you a pedophile.
Okay, but it gets posted a lot, especially for people. But so you see the problem, right? Okay, so...
Okay, we're getting hella hyperbolic.
Okay, I'm sorry, you're right. So this is the problem. The problem with Gamergate is both sides started to spend all their time attacking positions that don't exist. Anita Sarkeesian, for example, to point out a pro-Gamergate thing, started talking about a whole bunch of stupid shit about how Gamergate supports, like, mass female rapes and excluding female from gaming, etc., 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 and tried to paint herself to be the hero for standing against that, when in reality, not very many people really supported that. There, it would be hard-pressed to find a lot of reasonable people that think that, that, like, women should be excluded from gaming and it's okay if women get raped, blah, blah, blah.
Reasonable people, Steve. That's the point.
Okay, we're never, I don't think we're ever gonna agree on this.
No, okay, I think the problem is we both interrupt each other for 2 seconds.
No. I think that you do the no true Scotsman thing really hard. I think that for people that you agree with, you look at their point of view and then you give them all sorts of like you give them a lot of leeway, like, oh well, when they did this or being satirical, oh, when they blah 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 blah. But if it's somebody that you disagree with, you hold them, every person in that group, to the most logical extremity that you can, from the most fringe people. No, I haven't done that to you at all, have I?
Well, I mean, I don't know. You do seem to think that there are people in SRS who legitimately believe that all men are rapists.
I do think that there are some of them that think that a large portion of the Reddit user base is, yeah, sure. Or that when a Reddit user base, like, making fun of, like, one of the saddest things that I see SRS do is making fun of that, like, epolophile versus pedophile or whatever, right? Do you know what I'm talking about?
I don't actually know what that is.
So, I don't... Sometimes people talk about, like, oh, like, if you like a 16-year-old, that doesn't make you a pedophile, and then SRS is like, oh, no, they're just, like, epobophiles or whatever, because there's, like, another word for it or whatever.
Iblubophiles.
Yeah, that thing. But you do know that pedophilia refers to, like, a very specific thing, like liking children.
Okay, just give me 30 seconds uninterrupted. It's not about pedantry. Okay. The point is, it's not, we aren't like, okay, yes, sometimes you're gonna, I confess, this is public record. I, an above legal age, radical feminist, sometimes see 16-year-olds and go, yes, they're attractive. That's not the issue. The issue is that there are a lot of people on Reddit and out there, mostly on Reddit, but sometimes out there in real life, who take every single stance that they can to shoehorn in this weird sympathy for pedophile and pedophile issues, and I don't
see. I totally disagree with that, but go ahead. Okay. I don't think you'll find anybody on Reddit. I would be like really hard pressed. Find me an upvoted post on Reddit where people are actively like defending child molestation.
No, but it's never that flat. Like, it's never that. Okay.
So it doesn't happen.
No, that's not necessarily true. You're doing the thing. Remember when you said, like, the stupid internet argument where a person makes 6 points and pick holes in one, and then that's the...
Yeah, sure. Well, I mean, we can talk about anything. I'm not trying to, like, win an argument. I'm just having a discussion.
Okay, then, if we're just trying to have a discussion, in the same way that racism isn't always lynching black people, and there's a broad spectrum of really complicated, sometimes completely subconscious methods and motivations and beliefs that go into making a person racist or not racist. Like, so subtle. Oh my god. Same with sexism, same with...
Okay,
sexism,
sure, but
blah,
like...
Blah, blah, blah.
Being
there's
a...
shades.
But the, this is gonna sound like... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
I don't think that Redditors, like, by and large, are rapists or, like, advent... racist or sexist or whatever, but I do believe that in this culture a lot of people pick up on subtle nuances that are problematic, and what groups like SRS and a lot of radical feminist groups, because it's fun to rally, Stephen, and everyone does it, is they pull
not everyone
on it,
but
a lot of people
go ahead. Yeah,
come,
yeah, no, I agree. Yep, go ahead. I'm sorry,
it's not when we say all fucking like all Redditors or rapists or whatever, we're not actually saying that all Redditors want to rape people. We're talking for perhaps about the mass upvoted Ask Reddit thread, where users asked rapists to share their experiences, and the rapist came forward and gave these watered down, like, this is what happened to me things, and the comment sections were full of people that were dismissing the charges against them, going, oh, well, you made a mistake, dude. When we talk about Reddit being full of rapists, we aren't talking about, like, Redditors literally by the millions going out violating other people. We're talking about that Magic the Gathering post made recently, where a man was, I'm just going to quote this from the news article, convicted with extensive evidence of anally and vaginally raping a blackout drunk woman who was slumped over a toilet. That person did that, got out after 6 months because of Rich Daddy-O, and then tried to re-enter the Magic tournament scene, and the thread was filled with people not only praising his return, but demonizing one other Magic commentator who the only thing they did was let people at the local tournament know that a convicted rapist would be
attended. Can you link the thread?
I totally can. It's like super upvoted. But that's what I mean. It's not literally everyone's a rapist. It's just that there's a lot
of... Wait, can you link that? I want to see that thread. I really want to see that thread.
Like right now?
Yes, okay, right now. I really want to see that thread.
Okay, yeah, I can find it. Fuck.
I feel like there's nuance that you're missing here. But we'll see it.
There's always nuance. Everyone's going to miss it.
Well, but some nuance can be really important. So I'm really curious.
Sure. Okay, wait. But I'm on my phone, so just a second. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Magic the Gathering Rapist. Oh. Top post on Google. Shit Reddit says. That's probably what I'm looking for. Oh my fucking god, it's Reddit's mobile site. I don't know how to navigate this. Okay,
ooh,
wait.
I don't think you can get out of it either. I've tried to request a desktop version of the site and it won't work. I hate that mobile
shit.
What
the fuck? Desktop working is great. It's what everyone's used to. Just keep it for the phone. Who has a small phone screen these days?
Yeah, I know. I think
poor people?
People thought that phone, like mobile, like web browsing was gonna be like really important, but I think that people should just use the normal fucking pages, like phones have gotten to all have 1080p or even 1440 display sometimes. Like, I think we can drop the mobile site shit.
Yeah, like, okay, like, I know some people are still using their flip phones from the 1960s, but this is, I mean, it's like, I can read just fine. Okay, here we go. In light of recent how many upvotes does this thing have? 1,240. That's a lot for a Magic the Gathering.
They probably hit RL, so they get a lot more.
I think it got best of.
Okay.
Which is disgusting. Here. Okay, so, Steven, I just want to preface this.
Preface, no, but okay, no, go ahead.
Is it preface?
I think so. I don't know. I'm pretty sure it is. But go ahead. I was wrestling your jams. Go ahead.
Okay. So I'm very young, you see. I don't know every word. What this is a very long post that is a very neutrally worded pseudo-apology from one professional to a community. There's not much to read between, like, there's a lot to read between the lines here. If you take some time to look at the charges upon which this person was successfully convicted and kind of read into the neutral tone with which we refer to the vaginal anal raping of I think she was 17 too. I don't remember. That could be false, but I slumped over a toilet like I'm a girl. That's when this whole thing starts to take life. That's when this post reads like someone who is not at all ashamed of what they did. Sorry, not sorry, their way back into the hearts of a community who just didn't really care that someone they like is a convicted rapist. So,
did you like me the thread?
I'm about to. I had to get... Here we go. How do you copy... Okay, there we go. I don't know how to use phones. Phones are hard. Here we go. Why do you want this thread?
Because I'm curious if it's as bad as you say it is. I don't think it is. I feel like I would know that. I feel like one of the follies of SRS is that they tend to think that things are like way worse than they actually are. And it sounds like you're doing that now. But so I'm curious if it actually is as bad as it is.
Okay. No. Yeah. No. And you're gonna read this, and it's entirely possible that you're gonna see it and go, "Well, this isn't so bad." But, and that's true.
All right. Somebody liked it. Somebody liked it in my chat, so I have it now. I'll read it after this game.
We do. You just got DP'd, dude. Send Skype too. Oh. And you can read into that whatever you like, but the description that I provided is accurate. So just put it when you're done with your league game. But the point that I'm making, Steven, is that it's not everyone being a rapist or everyone being a pedophile. It's just these subtle nuances that get picked up and upvoted time after time again. I mean, how can you blame people for thinking Reddit is got a really shitty user base after Reddit literally caught on fire 2 days ago? After a subreddit which existed for the sole and only reason of despising fat people.
Do you understand why a lot of people are mad?
Because they're stupid.
You're not making. You need to make. You need to make a good. This is something that I have to do with my mom a lot, and this will help you. This is one of the reasons why you could never like change my mind. Okay, I'm not. Okay, first of all, it sounds like you condescend me every time you say my name. But the reason this is really important. You don't. You're like. You're really bad at doing this. Okay, so fuck you. Okay, you need to understand why people that disagree with you disagree with you. Okay, the reason
why
people
disagree with me.
Why?
Okay. Complex series of interrelated social and cultural.
No. Why do you think people are mad? Tell me if you think. Why people are mad about the whole fat hate thing getting...
Are you asking me if I'm capable of empathy?
Sure. Empathize with your opponent, sure. I don't even want you to be empathetic, I just want you to be rational. Tell me why you think...
I'm not an irrational person.
Okay, then tell me,
Tell me.
Go, tell me.
Okay, fine. Yes, they had a subreddit in the community, probably where they contributed very often, and for reasons that were not ubiquitously applied across all subreddits, their subreddit specifically was deleted, despite the fact that many of them seem to believe, or perhaps have evidence to the fact that, they did not participate in many of the brigades that they were accused of participating
in. Oh my god, that
was like... It makes them feel as though they exist on a site that is actively, dedicatedly trying to remove their forum for discussion. And they are now scrambling, angrily, scrambling, to try and find a place where they can reconnect over the same unified interest, I suppose.
Yeah, so that was good. So the inability of the Reddit admins to follow the policies that they... Or follow the rationale that they put forth for banning this up is why people are mad. Which I can understand. I think that that's a reasonable reason to be upset over something. Whether or not the subreddit that was banned was like kind of a shitty subreddit. For me personally, I don't like any Circle Jerk subreddits. I don't really feel... I didn't like browse it often, so I really don't care much.
It was a really shitty subreddit.
But the problem is there are a lot of really shitty subreddits, so...
There's nothing wrong with doing things for moral reasons.
There is a wrong thing about doing it for a moral reason and lying about the reason you're doing it, though.
It's a private website. I mean, they can do whatever the fuck they want.
They can, and people can protest if they want.
I agree. The rules should have been applied more ubiquitously. I want to see all non-feminist subs raised to the ground.
Okay,
hyperbolic.
Yeah.
I want to see a lot of subs raised to the ground. Fat people hate, shit niggers say, neo-fat. These were some of the ones I wanted to see burned. Am I upset that they're gone? No. Should the admins have gone farther in destroying subreddits I don't like? Yes. Do I understand
why? Okay, so
why
if you
upset?
Understand why people are so upset, then why are you so surprised or why are you counter-upset about it?
I'm not surprised. I understood.
Then why are you upset that they're upset?
I'm not upset that they're upset. I'm half amused at how they're expressing their discontent and half really happy that they're upset.
You shouldn't be happy. You really shouldn't. Let me throw a counterexample. Let's say that Reddit had an admin who was like a known like oh my god.
Steven, rational and impartial are not synonyms. You know that, right?
Let's say that there was a leader. Let's say that there, or I'm sorry, let's say the CEO of Reddit was actually like a men's rights activist, okay? Let's say that the CEO of Reddit, who's a men's rights activist, were to remove the SRS subreddit, and the reason why they removed it was because it had extremist ideology, but then it left up like men's rights or neo-Nazi or shit niggers say or whatever. Let's say it left up all those subreddits. Wouldn't that upset you that they claim to remove SRS because of radical ideology, but they left other radical subreddits out? Wouldn't that be, like, unnerving to you?
Like I said, I do understand why they're upset. And
yeah, so then
upset.
Why would you celebrate Steven, when somebody's upset for what you just said is, like, a legitimate reason?
Isn't... Rational isn't the same as impartial. It's okay.
So
Steven,
then you admit
something...
that your, like, decision to be happy about them being upset isn't, like, anything based in rationality? You're just, like...
No, it's based in partiality. I am partial against them. I rationally understand why they're upset. And they have a right to be upset. Their upsetness is valid. I don't disagree that they should be upset. I just think that they're shitty people. And it's okay when bad things happen to shitty people. And that's not irrational.
There's a quote.
What is it, from Voltaire? Please don't quote Voltaire.
Is it?
Is it the "I will die"? I don't believe what you say, but I'll defend to the death. You're right to say it.
No, it's the one. Does this come from a play? Like a really old, not Shakespeare. Basically, the quote is something like, "Would you break the law if you could to prosecute the devil?" And some guy was like, "I would cut down every law I could, blah blah blah, in order to convict the devil." And then the guy is like, "Well, at the end of all of that, what would there be left to protect yourself with?" Have you ever heard of this quote? I'm butchering it.
I understand where you're going with.
The problem, like, let me put it this way. I really don't let me put it this way. I hate the SRS subreddit, okay? For a lot of reasons.
I really do, okay?
But if the SRS subreddit got removed...
You know they hate me too, right?
Sure. But if the SRS subreddit got removed for extremist ideology, and then a whole bunch of other subreddits stayed up, that wouldn't really be something that I would be happy with. Because obviously Reddit lied about the reasons why they took it down. Why are you lying about it? Like, you can't just come out and say it? Does that mean that you don't actually think you made a good decision? And then the fact that it's being applied...
That you say it.
What?
I I agree they should say it. But there's a difference between how I believe things should be conducted on this website and how I believe things should be conducted in real life. If constitutional amendments were made to remove protections for...
But this is like extreme. Like, this is like really extremist stuff. I'm not getting into extremist examples. This is a very real example.
This is a perfect parallel. In the real life with the government and the
All right. Well, none of this is worth.
Dude.
Well, I'm just saying that this is all a waste of a conversation then, because you're saying not everything is a waste. You're saying like I am being irrational. I am being unfair because I'm partial. So then there's nothing to talk about. Like we're never gonna agree on this.
No, that's not what I'm. It's serious.
Yeah.
Do you believe that's a rational analysis of what I'm saying from your mind?
Yes. You're essentially saying that I don't care that the rules were applied in a bad way here.
Taking that from what I'm saying, dude.
Because you're...
I don't believe she should have lied. I think what she should have said is, these subs are shitty, filled with shitty people, and shitty people should have things happen to them, then shut them down. Yes, I would be upset if that happened to the subreddit side. Like, I don't believe in a shitty person. No, Chairman Power, whatever they're calling her these days, is not an impartial judge of what is good or what is bad. But I
okay,
do
so
believe,
then...
from a greater perspective, that yes, believing in the equality of certain peoples, even if you're overzealous in doing so, is preferable.
That's not right,
sense.
Though. You don't even agree with that statement. You're saying the ends justify the means. I could eliminate gender dysphoria. That's what you're saying. You could eliminate gender dysphoria by killing all transgendered people.
On Reddit, dude. If the government started prosecuting neo-Nazis or like KKK rallies, I would genuinely be upset. I'm an advocate for the ACLU's right to protect every single person's right to freedom of speech. These are Reddit. This, I know that you and I both live on the internet, but there was more to it than that.
I don't think we're ever going to agree on this.
Okay, then what? So you believe that I am so partial that I'm just like, fuck people who disagree with me? But in real life, obviously...
If your subreddits got removed for the same reason these ones did, and it was done in a haphazard way that wasn't applied evenly across Reddit, I think you would be upset, and I think you would have a good reason to be upset. But when it happens to somebody else, and because you happen to disagree with them ideologically, you don't think that they're worthy of the same protections you are, because you come from a different ideological background. I totally disagree with that. But that's what you're saying, and you've admitted it. So it's like...
Right to ban feminists, and that's fine. I don't get bothered by that at all. In a feminist website, they have every right to ban minorities. I don't have any problem with that at all. It's a private website curated by private people. It's a website I spend a lot of time on. I want that website to better reflect my views.
Okay, none of this has anything to do with what we're talking about, though. Whatever, all the stuff you're talking about, better website.
You honestly think I have this political ideology because I think it's funny that shitty people lost their subreddit? What if the subreddit was? They have like a billion people. Do you seriously think everyone they're quoting over the destruction of these subreddits is some sort of extremist who just takes pleasure in the destruction of the property?
No, I think Ellen got rid of the subreddit for a few reasons. Personally, I think it has to do with advertising caving in, and maybe it comes out of their personal belief as well.
Who the fuck cares, Steven? It's fat people hate. It's Reddit. It's the internet. I cannot believe I'm having
I care because I like to be ideologically consistent in what I believe. That's why
okay,
I care.
Here's my ideological consistency, okay? The world is really complicated and a lot of bad things
this
happen.
Is a pretty...
You don't deserve it. I think the way to improve the quality and fairness of the
is
world...
to make other bad things happen to people that you think do deserve
no,
it? You realize the...
Discourage. What bad things? Are we taking their property? No, we're just eliminating...
Stop! No, that's so wrong. This is a bad thing. This is an objectively bad thing. A subreddit getting removed for these people is an objectively bad thing.
Why?
What do you mean, why? Because it's a subreddit, because they like to fucking post fat people hate or whatever in their subreddit.
Dude,
it's an objectively bad thing. Wait, hold on. Do you think that it's not a bad thing if a subreddit that you frequent a lot gets removed? Do you not think
why?
That's a bad thing? Just answer that, yes or no.
But that's not even a relevant question.
It is, because you're trying to say that it's not even a bad thing now, when it clearly is.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
When slavery was outlawed, many white people were upset, and many black people were happy. Since their upsetness and happiness cancels out, it was a mutual decision. Progress moves in one direction. I understand that was
so again, you're just comparing, you're saying that your ends justify the means. That's exactly what that is, right? You realize it.
The upsetness of the people who were made mad when slavery was outlawed was justified by slavery being outlawed. The upsetness of people... This is so hyperbolic, dude.
It's not at all hyperbolic. It's actually, like, a very easy-to-follow analogy. I completely disagree. We'll never agree on this. We really won't.
You disagree? So you think slavery shouldn't have been... Wait, what?
I disagree that just because you disagree with somebody else means that you have a right to disrespect them in all sorts of different ways and that they should be treated on a much different level than you. I completely disagree with that.
Let's argue this on different levels. Do you think that Pau had a right as an owner of a private website to curate her content as she saw fit? Do you think she had a right?
Yeah, of course. But just because she has a right to do, I have a right to go outside and stand on the street corner and scream, I hate niggers and Jews all day long. But that doesn't make you not an asshole. It doesn't make you morally or ethically incorrect, though. So I don't understand what the point of bringing that up is.
Okay, well then let's argue this in levels then. So you believe she was an asshole in doing that?
Yeah, I think that what she did was ethically or morally wrong. I think that she should have been more clear about her reasonings and then applied it consistently across all of Reddit. That would have avoided a lot of people getting upset, I think.
Okay, so your problem... Okay, we just need to calm down. So your problem isn't actually the fact that these subreddits got banned. It's that she...
No, like I said, I think if she wanted to ban them, they were like, she could find good reasons to. And I think there was good reasons, especially if they were harassing people and whatnot. But I don't agree with the way that she did it, because her definitions for harassment are inconsistent and other subreddits follow it, and there are worse subreddits out there, so it doesn't make sense for that. Like, it's just weird. That's what I'm upset about. That's what we established when I asked you. I initially asked you, remember, why do you think people are mad? And then you gave the correct definition. You said you said, oh, well, they're mad because,
and I think it's okay for people to be mad at stupid things. It doesn't mean that they're...
But that's not a stupid thing. Being mad that somebody is inconsistently applying your ideology is not a stupid thing.
So would you have been upset if she had just flatly said,
I wouldn't have at all.
No, Steven.
What?
Would you have been upset if she just flatly said, I disagree with the content of these subreddits, I am the private owner of this site, I pay the bills, they are to be done away with? What about that? That's so,
no, because
so
then she's being
flat.
Totally honest. Yeah, that's exactly blunt. I would think, I would disagree with it in terms of, like, I don't think that that's necessarily the direction Reddit should go, because I think that's kind of weird. But I mean, it would be like, oh, okay. I mean, you can't really get mad about it.
I agree completely, because I like being around people who share similar values in the same way that you've been trying to end this conversation for 15 minutes because you and I don't share similar
I'm
values.
I'm trying to end the conversation.
I agree. She should have been very, very explicit in the reasons why she banned those subreddits. I'm really glad we could work out this inconsistency.
That's what I've been saying the entire time.
Yes, and you've been saying that I've been a rat. I don't know.
Because you seem to say that it doesn't matter because those people were assholes anyway, so who cares if they're subreddit got fucked?
Why are you saying that they're being offended is like a legitimate argument against anything? I thought that's what Tumblrites did.
It has nothing to do with being offended. It has to do with them being upset that the things are being applied, that rules are being applied inconsistently across Reddit, which I think is like a legitimate concern.
Okay, I agree. But do you believe that's, like, solely the reason why they're upset? Do you seriously think the reason...
No, I'm sure there are a lot of people that are genuinely shitty people. That subreddit was filled with a lot of genuinely shitty people.
Okay,
when you go to a subreddit that's just dedicated to hating other people, there's probably something wrong with yourself.
Okay, so there we go. I found the problem. It's the lack of clarity. I agree. The people who are upset at rules being improperly or ubiquitously applied, that upsetness is legitimate. And because that's a neutral upsetness, I don't disagree with it. They are legitimate in that being upset over that. However, I think that constitutes about 6%.
You're doing the thing again where it's like, okay, well, this side that I disagree with is overwhelmingly filled with horrible people. My side, though, that I agree with is overwhelmingly filled with good people. That's what you're saying.
Said,
no, that's
you
what
you just said.
You just said
it's full of...
Yeah, but I didn't give a percentage. I didn't say that only 6% of the people on Reddit that are mad are mad. Well, no, you're being...
Do you think I pulled out my fucking calculus for that? I don't know. 12%, maybe 99% of them are upset for legitimate reasons.
Okay, well, that's a lot different. That's a lot different than...
Okay, well, let's look at the evidence then, Stephen. We're looking at a subreddit that A, has a homophobic slur in the title, B, has, like, the worst word in the English language. Like, it's, come on.
Wait, fat people hate? Or is there a different subreddit you're talking about now?
Shit nigger said.
Oh, okay, what about that one? Oh, is that one that was banned or whatever, or...?
Yeah, it was banned. There were like four subreddits that were banned. I forget what the fourth one was, but it was Neo Fags, Shit Nigger Says, and Fat People Hate.
Okay.
If we break down those subreddits, I don't actually know anything about Neo Fags. I knew nothing about it, so I am not qualified to speak. Maybe they were fine people. Probably not because of that name, but whatever. Shit Nigger Says, nothing needs to be said there. Fat People Hate, I hope nothing needs to be said there. Judging from the content and population of these subreddits, I'm going to take, I believe, a reasonable guess that the moral fiber of the people who are upset over this is relatively low. Not entirely. I'm sure there were fine people there, but I think that I have good reason to believe that a lot of them are upset for reasons that I believe are fairly objectively shitty. You can't argue with that.
Why not?
We shouldn't be.
I mean, yeah. I'm actually upset for the reasons given that those subreddits were banned, and I'm upset that they weren't applied evenly across Reddit.
But my problem, Steven, is in the same way that you've accused me in the past of throwing in my hat with other people for like these vague, obtuse reasons. When you say that you're like upset with them, don't you see that you kind of, by doing that, you like assume the group? In the same way that when you start defending Gamergate when it gets brought up.
No, I don't agree with that at all.
You're not just defending them, ethics and gaming journalism. There are camps, Steven. There are always camps. There have always been and there always will be camps. None of us are above it. None of us exist outside of society or the demographics. We just have to accept that. We're just small, tiny ants moving across a gigantic global stage. Most of us are going to die without being remembered for much more than a couple generations. We're defined by the groups we support.
How is that relevant to anything that we just talked about?
Because when I say that I agree with SRS or GamerVazi or whatever, what I'm saying really at the end of the day is that I support the general feminist, whatever.
Okay, but I think it's possible to do that. I think it's possible to support the general ideologies of feminism. I think I do a lot more today than I ever used to. But I still disagree with the bannings of these subreddits for the reasons given. And I think that you can disagree for the banning of those subreddits for the reason given and not be like a horrible hypocrite or not be like a totally like fucked person.
I agree, but can you understand how that might get confusing for me when I hear you go off the ropes on that, Steven?
I don't think it should be confusing at all.
Well, like I said, there are camps, and right, you know how Reddit caught fire? Like, people mass upvoting, like, thousands and thousands of upvotes with
sure.
no comments.
People react in dumb ways when they get scorned. Yeah, it happens all the time. I don't think it's necessarily right or wrong, but people from every kind of background do that shit. When people get
dumb
mad at shit.
Wrong.
What?
Dumb, like, it wasn't just dumb. Dumb is what I do every morning when I decide that.
Okay, dumb or wrong. Yeah, sure, dumb or wrong. How many, yeah. I mean, people do that kind of shit all the fucking time. I don't agree, necessarily agree with it. I don't know if it was handled the best way.
How people behave in tough situations is indicative of their character.
Nobody behaves. Nobody behaves well in tough situations. There is
no
group of people that have ever.
I lose my shit too sometimes. But there's a difference between acting poorly and acting like bigoted or like shitty. You know, I lose my shit. Not the same. There's a difference between someone who acts like an asshole when they get mad and someone who shouts racial slurs when they get mad. Both of them are acting like assholes, but one of them, like everyone's an asshole when they're mad, but one of them is revealing something about themselves because non-racists
don't shout racial slurs. I upvoted a few of those things that
I thought
they were. What? I upvoted a few of those threads because some of them were funny because I think, I don't know, I mean, it's what do you do? I disagree that, like, mob mentality and all that shit is, like, really fucked. I don't think that you can make any judgments about
we're
large
all
groups
a part
of people.
Of the mob.
Exactly. So that's why I don't think you can make, like, any judgments about groups of people based
from
on
mob mentality.
Yeah, I don't agree with that necessarily.
Like, what about, like, the race riots in the 50s? Like, they were really angry over some.
Honestly, I guarantee you that there were a lot of really good people that were just racist growing up because they were born around it their
yeah.
entire
no,
fucking life.
No, I agree.
Yeah.
I don't hate bigoted people, dude. Because like I keep saying, and no one ever fucking listens to me, we're just the products of society.
To some extent,
like,
yeah, sure.
It. Nothing matters but society. Does anyone, apart from like the great men theory, everyone remembers Genghis Khan, no one gives a shit about whatever the name of some Mongolian person would have been in 8 fuck BC. Nobody cares. All that matters is society. When we're dead and buried, society is all that's gonna matter. So I try and judge things from a larger perspective. Reddit's a pretty fucking big site, and it has a massive cultural influence. I mean, I know it's like the internet and all, but it's pretty big. So when I see sites being curated like this, you know, the removal of people that are pretty morally unconscionable, I don't see their frustration. Oh, it's bad. The rules were inapplied. And all I see is 3 years from now, Reddit's going to have a community that hopefully will be rid of these people, and
okay.
That's bigger.
I mean, we're never gonna agree on that. Like, my point of view didn't change on that. I don't think it's okay to tear down the rules to get to some people that you don't like. I think that you just fuck yourself ultimately by doing
you,
that.
You don't tear down the rules.
You are. She is, but she didn't in this case. She banned the subreddits for some reason, and she never said why.
Would you? Okay, so she did a bad thing. Do you
yeah.
think that doing a bad thing for a good reason can, like...
No, because I don't believe that the ends justify the means. No.
Okay, the whole, like, dichotomy of whether or not you believe in the extra fine demeans is really, really misleading, because everyone does to some extent. If you could, like, slap your mother in the face to get $1 billion and split it 50-50 with her, you'd be willing to contend that the ends in that case did justify the means.
Well, yeah, but that's because what did you accomplish? By doing something relatively harmless to your mother, you acquired $1 billion. That's a really good thing. Whereas
$1 billion quadrillion.
Sure, whatever, any amount of money over fucking 100,000 or even fucking 10,000, fuck. However, however, what the Ellen whatever chick did, what she did was she lied. She lied, Ellen Powell. What she did is she lied about how she applied the rules, and she did that to push an agenda. That's, I don't think that's like a thing that's worth fucking consistency over for.
I don't know. I don't think that rule consistency on a website that you can make free accounts on is honestly that big a thing. I think it sucks. I think she should apply the rules fairly. But we all make trade-offs when we talk about ends justifying means. Like, everyone.
Okay, I don't think that's like a good trade-off then at all. That's what I need to
then,
say.
So, okay, that's fine. But I guess that really depends on how much we care about the rules in a website versus how much we care about hundreds of thousands of people who make it their pastime to harass and bully.
It's not an either or. It's not an either or. This is a false dichotomy.
It was the ends versus means dichotomy.
No, it's not. That's a real thing. When you cut down the rules to achieve some kind of end, then those rules are gone and they can no longer protect you in the future. What if we get some Reddit CEO admin?
Reddit rules ever been applied consistently?
I mean, I don't know. So they just don't matter at all anymore?
This is important. If they never had any consistency, then them being broken doesn't mean anything at all.
I mean, I think the rules were like relatively consistent. So now we're just going into the nihilism of nothing means anything and...
No, we're going into the how much... It's like if you...
Okay, I'm sorry. We're like into like totally off territory. Listen, I'm upset with what Ellen did. I'm upset because she was inconsistent in how she applied the ruling. She lied about how she did it. And that's why I'm upset. And I think that there are plenty of people that don't have to be bad people that can be genuinely upset about that. And I think that most people that are rational people should be upset that it was done in that specific way. That's why I...
But do you believe that most rational people should also feel that the negatives of that outweigh the positives of the outcome of that?
You're saying that the positives outweigh the negatives?
I do, in this case, believe that.
Okay, no, because part of the negatives are we've now said that it's okay for you to just plow through whatever rules just to ban something that you disagree with.
But the rules have never been applied consistently. Because
of the rating rule? But people get mad about that, too. Are you saying that nobody gets upset about the... Why do you think SRS is brought up so often?
Well, like the vote brigading rules. I agree that rules... should be applied consistently. I don't disagree with that slightly. Like, why?
Hold on, Mycom, do you have solid evidence that she lied, or are you just following a circle jerk? The rationale that she gave for getting rid of Fat People Hate is because she was saying they were doing targeted harassment of people outside of Reddit or whatever. That was the reason that she gave for banning it.
Which was true.
Okay, yeah, but SRS did that to me. But they never got banned for it, and to other people as well.
Okay, but there's a difference in heinousness.
Okay, so you're saying that the people, if somebody posted a picture of you and called you fat, that's worse than trying to destroy my career? You think there's a difference in heinousness? I agree there's a difference in heinousness, but I don't think that the fat person made...
There's a difference between a 150,000 person sub deliberately targeting the owners of a website and, like, insulting them and doxing them.
So where do you draw... So how many people have to be involved before it's called into... Like, this is... You're getting into, like, really weird territory, right?
Well,
like,
there's a difference between the numbers SRS polls and the numbers that fat people...
So at what number does it become unacceptable?
Do you think I know that? And second question, is it relevant?
Yes, it's very relevant.
Are you still mad that we tried to destroy your career? You used to...
I'm not mad about it. I'm not mad about it. I'm not mad about it at all.
Why do you keep bringing it up?
Because it's relevant to the discussion.
Okay, what in your mind? Okay, I'm actually curious because I don't know myself. This is totally subjective. What in your mind is the difference between a small community deliberately pursuing goals? In one particular case, removing you from your career, like, I don't know, like a community of book readers trying to get harass somebody for whatever. What's the difference between a community pursuing a goal and harassment? Like, what in your
mind? If that goal is harassment, then there's no difference. What you're trying to...
No, there's a...
You're playing semantics so hard. Well, these people weren't harassing you. These people were pursuing the goal of ending your career.
Wanting to destroy someone's career.
What?
Okay. Is it harassment if a bunch of people call for the removal of a sports player after allegations occur of them, like, beating their wife or something? Would you consider that harassment? Or would you consider that a group of people who have interest in the subject, like, testing over something that they care about?
I mean, you're starting...
Fair question.
So, like, so here's the thing. Like, you're getting into all these finer things, and I can't really answer, but the problem is Ellen didn't either, but she made an arbitrary ruling. That so, like...
Yeah, no, it's all arbitrary. Have you looked at the U.S. legal... The law has always been arbitrary, but this is a serious question, dude.
What does that have to do with anything?
That has to do with the fact that if you can't separate the difference from harassment and a community, like, pursuing an interest involving...
Okay, what about when the StarCraft Circle Jerk subreddit posted my dick as part of the Reddit CSS on their subreddit?
That was a massive violation of your privacy.
Yeah, but that subreddit didn't get banned.
I think they should have had actual legal charges brought against.
Yeah, but the subreddit didn't even get banned. In fact, you know what? I bet that picture is still being hosted on Reddit. No, it's probably not.
I remember on SRS, somebody said they were, like, super hard pursuing some group of people. I don't know who, for that to be removed, right? I think that was removed.
I don't know.
Did you see me in those subreddit drama threads? I think I was the top voted post saying that, like, hey, man, I know Destiny guy, but this is really shitty.
I don't...
But did you see that?
That was in subreddit drama. There's a lot of crossover between the two communities, but...
There's a fuck.
Lot of the meta subs are split really heavily. I don't know if you noticed that. Half the meta subs are, like...
That's all I go on. Bad history, bad philosophy, bad economics...
I don't like that because I can never, because it's stupid. I don't think it's conducive to anything. A lot of the subs are split into that hardcore SRS group, and the other half are split into the hardcore anti-SRS group. So it makes all of it
SRD is not SRS light. I mean, you can say what you want.
Subreddit drama is definitely SRS light. You're absolutely delusional if you think it's not.
Drink.
They use a lot of the same. They use a lot of the same verbiage. You see a lot of, like, oh, like, this guy's a shitlord. There are a lot of people that post in both, although people try not to do it, but it's really obvious based on the way that they talk. When people talk about, like, oh, pedo apologists and shit, like. There's very obviously... I'm not saying that it's like a negative...
Pedo-apologist has existed for a long time as a term.
Sure.
What if the internet's just changing? I mean, what if... Okay, like, I know this sounds like super fucking conceited, but what if the people who share my opinions...
Welcome to the League of Dreaming.
...the culture war?
I mean, whether or not they are, I agree more with a lot of the things that, quote-unquote, your people say or whatever, but I don't think that on any side of history, I don't think anybody's ever thought that it's good that people have done, like, really fucked up, illegal, horrible fucking shit, and then all of a sudden, you know, that made what they accomplished at the end okay. In fact, in history, oftentimes it's...
Banning fat people hate was a fucked up, horrible, illegal shit.
That's not what was fucked up and horrible. If she would, like I said, if she would have... You're missing the point. If she would have made an announcement saying, fat people hate is being banned because, honestly, I think this sub is fucking disgusting as fuck, and I don't like that they harass people. And it's like, oh, well, fuck, I mean, rip. Then maybe they could get mad because other people...
But I've already agreed with you.
Okay, but banning it for one reason and then not banning other subreddits that all fall under that criteria... is weird.
Look, on one hand, I do kind of sympathize slightly with the misapplication of rules, because at the end of the day, even if your rules are ubiquitous, some problems are going to be bigger than others. If there's an anti-harassment policy and there's a subreddit with like 200 people that occasionally brigades, you're going to go after fat people paid first. That's just how it works. Maybe this is part of a larger culling. I doubt it, because they've been known to inconsistently apply rules in the past. But I do think that sometimes an issue becomes so like massive and to the forefront that like it's even like it almost in a way justifies the way that the rules are misapplied. There isn't some gigantic legal rule book on Reddit rule and no one would follow it anyway, but it's like fat people hate was like the mods were actually like post like taking off Facebook, Twitter, like just people, they were taking people off shitty no matter what you believe. Like if you hate fat, come on, just they were doing that and they were getting uploaded to all. I mean, this was a big problem.
My penis is still on Reddit servers.
That's really shitty, dude. Look,
sorry.
I'm an exhibitionist. Why doesn't anyone put my penis on
Reddit? Hey, I mean, I could be too. Maybe that's why I made that thread. The front page, all of Reddit got to see my dick. Probably more than most people in the world.
I'm very happy to say I didn't take a look at those pictures because they were taken or posted without your consent. It would have been.
Sure. It would have been rape almost, right?
No.
But, this post was a number one on Reddit and r/all, and it's still hosted on Reddit servers. It's kind of annoying. I don't think we're ever going to agree on this. I don't agree.
No. For her to inconsistently apply the rules.
Yeah, I don't like taking out people that I disagree with. I don't like taking them down using nefarious means or breaking rules to do it and then feeling good about that afterwards. That feels like a hollow victory.
Do you feel good hanging out around me?
Sure, I like talking to you. You challenge my point of view. It's interesting conversations.
All right, fair. So, do you believe there's any threat on Reddit that would have been heinous enough that an inconsistent application of rules would have been justified by...
No, because the more heinous it is, the more rational it would be to make some kind of rule saying that it needs to go.
So you think she should just consistently apply?
Yeah, but make rule. If it's something like this is like a subreddit, or like we're no longer allowing subreddits dedicated to like hating on groups of people or shitting on groups of people or something like that, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Although that might, the ruling might start to get like, you might start to draw a lot of weird lines in this.
It's
like,
always gonna be vague. I mean, the U.S.
Yeah.
laws.
Like, but I mean, at the very least, then we have like a consistent ruling to go on, and then we can argue about the consistencies. Whereas right now, she's clearly applied a rule that's inarguably being applied inconsistently, which just makes it feel really strange.
I agree that it's strange, and I also completely agree that I would be very upset if subs that I like got targeted for those reasons. I'm not
I would be upset as well. If SRS finally, got killed from Reddit and the reason was because of vote brigading, like, that doesn't feel like a very strong or good thing. Like, there's tons of subs. Fucking my subreddit of only 9,000 or 10,000 subs vote brigades, you know?
What about Best
hey
of?
Destiny,
fuck.
Could you please
yeah, sure.
link me your dick pic?
Best of
Thank you.
Nukes threads. I mean, actually...
Yeah, Best of and Worst of and all SRS, or Circle Broke and, subreddit drama. Yeah, there's all the meta threads, Nuke, the whatever thread they link to. It's inevitable. Even using
yeah,
the
like,
no participation links.
I like the meta Reddit. I fucking, that's where I spend my time. I wouldn't want all of that destroyed. So I agree. I think at the end of the day, the only thing that we can come to terms on is that we both agree that a consistent ruling would have been much more fair and much more clear. The only thing that we disagree on is that I don't think the consistency over rules on a private website is so abjectly.
Whether or not the site is private or public has nothing to do with anything. I'm not calling for like a constitutional thing or legal action.
Oh,
if we're
it
talking...
does. If there was a public website, like a government thing that did this, I would be furious. Like,
okay.
I would be absolutely
So you're okay
insane.
With people acting ethically dubious as long as they're a private individual and not a public individual?
Because there's a difference between when the state does something and when a private individual does something.
Okay, but if we're arguing morals or ethics, I don't see why it would make a big difference.
Well, yeah, because, I mean, one of those can snowball and one of those can't. What's the worst situation for Reddit? Everyone gets banned? Okay, go to vote, whatever.
The
man.
Worst situation for Reddit is one of the largest websites on the internet that is shaping the views of a lot of people is being manipulated by the personal viewpoints of just one or two people, like a CEO
yeah,
or
Yeah, no,
worker.
That's... Yeah, what do you think? What do you think the mainstream news networks is? There are bigger fights to fight if you're going to talk about private.
That's a logical fallacy that just because something is more important means you have to ignore everything else. That's like the people who are like, why would you donate to this when there are starving children in Africa?
Yeah, no, to a degree, that is a logical fallacy that I don't think we're engaging in a truth. Debate right now, but it's not
well. Sure,
problem,
I'm just saying that. I'm just saying that just because there are like bigger problems, I don't think that's okay to just accept.
But
that.
What I'm saying is, it's not a new problem, and it's a problem that's Reddit's like better.
Okay, just because
outlets.
This isn't a new problem, just because it happens elsewhere, just because it happens in worst degrees, doesn't mean you can't
I'm
be
not,
mad at this here. What the fuck?
I'm not saying that it should happen here. I'm saying there's a difference between when it happens in public and private. We already know what happens when a small group...
I know. There's a difference when it
like
happens
private.
In public and private in terms of, like,
but
legal
you asked
shit.
Me, you asked me what the difference would be from an ethical standpoint.
Yeah, because for ethics or morals, I don't think it
yeah,
should
we,
matter.
Yeah, because we already know what the end game is for private, like, control.
Let's say that I were to whip my fucking dick out, and every time Nathan walked by me in my house, I just fucking helicoptered all around. I was like, Nathan, are you jealous that your dick is as big as mine, right? If I were to do that in a public place, or even, like, in somebody else's private place,
okay,
I would get arrested for that. Wait, stop. I would get arrested for that, okay? And but if I were to do it in my own private house, would you be like, oh, well, at least...
Fallacy.
No. It's not... This isn't fallacious at all. What I'm saying is that, obviously, I'm using a hyperbolic example, but it holds true. You would say, no, you shouldn't wait... Stop. It doesn't matter. It's valid, okay? You would say, you shouldn't helicopter your dick in front of your kid because that's just fucking weird and wrong. And I would say, oh, well, you're absolutely right. It doesn't matter if this is public or not. Much the same way that somebody being morally or ethically dubious, it doesn't matter if it's a public or private thing.
Oh,
if you're
no,
being morally or ethically
it,
dubious,
it,
it's...
It does. Would you like to know why?
Sure.
Because as far as I'm concerned, in American media, the largest example of really heinous private control of, like, public discourse is Fox News. That's one of them. That's pretty fucking big. I mean, it's like a bajillion-dollar company. Whereas, if the government, the public, the state, was capable of improperly or ubiquitously executing its rules to get rid of dissenters or people with specific political opinions, I'm just gonna advoke this law. That's how the Nazis started, Stephen. Now, are you really saying that Chairman Pao is as bad as the Nazis?
What?
Now, that was argument out of
I'm just saying I'm just saying that I think that people shouldn't be shitting. It, just because they're a private individual doesn't give them the right, or just because they're a private individual or a private company doesn't give them the right to act morally dubious and then get away with it because they're
It certainly gives them a legal right.
Legally, but we're not talking about legally. We're talking about ethics and morals.
So we're talking about ethics.
You know this. We just said this. We've said this 50 okay. million times. We're talking about moral and ethical things.
Okay, so do you believe it's as unethical for Pau to do what she did as it would be for, like, a state legislator to explicitly ban the discussion of certain topics within the confines of the state? Do you think, like, the negative outcome of those two are roughly equivalent? Like, on an ethical level, do you think state censorship is in any way, shape, or form comparable to this? Because ethics takes into account severity. It's not some, like, totally pracks it out.
No, but just because one is less bad than the other doesn't make the other one okay. I think both of those are bad things. Maybe doing it on a larger scale would be worse, but that doesn't make the other thing suddenly acceptable.
That one of them isn't bad. You are still asking whether it would make a difference on an ethical level.
It doesn't make a difference in terms of whether... No. I didn't say it didn't make a difference of scale. I just said it didn't make a difference of right or wrong. Raping one person is bad.
Right or wrong.
No, it doesn't. Raping one person is bad. Raping 10 people is worse. But raping 10 people isn't wrong, and raping one person is right because it's of a lesser scale. Scale doesn't affect whether or not.
One is worse than the other.
Yeah, but they're both still wrong.
It isn't wrong.
But they're both still wrong. Oh, okay. Well, so then you still think that she's wrong. So then you still agree that she's wrong. Then that's fine. We can agree on it.
I never said otherwise. I've been agreeing with you on this for 30 fucking minutes.
Then what are we arguing about? Then what do you think we disagree with? Do you think
that I'm reading your chat and they're misquoting me and you're like, oh, that's what he said?
I'm not reading my chat. Listen, do you think that I think there's no difference in scale between a private person and the United States government? Do you think that I believe that?
I think that scale affects ethical weight.
Okay, but you don't think that I think that Ellen Pau has the same sway as the United States government, right?
No, I don't.
So then
think
why
that,
are you arguing about the difference in scale? Like, I don't understand the difference between the United States government and Ellen Pao. So if we agree on everything, why are we even arguing?
I don't know, because you thought that I was saying, after 30 minutes of saying otherwise, that I think it was okay for Pao to ubiquitously apply these rules. You just asked me what I thought the difference ethically was between a public and a private exercise of improper...
Okay, all right, let's move on from this, because I don't even know what we're disagreeing or arguing about anymore. It's all over.
That's what the entire discussion's been. No one knows what the fuck is going on. This is what happens.
I feel like I've been pretty consistent, and I feel like you're doing some weird shit.
And I feel like I've been pretty consistent, dude. And if I had a chat with 2,000 people to back me up, I'm sure they would say the same thing about me that your chat says about you. Can we please not do that? Come on. Let's both give each other some credit. I think you're an intelligent...
I don't want to. I think you said some things that are, like, unequivocally wrong.
And I think you said some sayings that are also unequivocally...
What do you think I've said that's unequivocally incorrect? That's, like, objectively, like, I should agree with you if I was a rational person.
Are we really gonna go down this path?
Yeah, just tell me one thing, and we'll talk about that one thing.
But why? We already disagreed on it. I thought, isn't arguing in circles something you're trying to avoid?
I'm just curious what something you think that I've said that's...
We're just here to gird...
Can you not? I just want you to tell me one thing that you think that I've said that if I was a perfectly rational individual, I would agree with you on.
Okay, I think that in a perfectly utilitarian sense, the good that came from removing some reactionary groups on Reddit outweighs the relatively minor problem of rules being inconsistently applied. And since ethics, good, evil, wrong, whatever, can be applied on a scale...
Okay, so you think that I'm absolutely incorrect when I say that I think that it's not worth it to take out one bad thing by breaking the rules that protect good things. You think I'm absolutely unequivocally incorrect there?
When the rules aren't, for one, it's not a slippery slope, because it's not like Ellen Pao is going to go on a subreddit banning spree. It really depends on what you think Ellen Pao is going to do with... What is this, newfound power? It's not newfound, she always had the power, she can do whatever the fuck she wants. Her choosing to be consistent with her rules, or not, isn't going to change what she does, because she has absolute authority over the website that she owns. So I don't think her decision to unubiquitously apply these rules or her reasoning would in any way, shape, or form change the outcome of Reddit as it will look in 6 months, 1 year, 2 years. I think that it's going to happen when she wants it to happen, and nothing we do or say, nothing she says to us, will change that outcome. So upon that reasoning, I do believe that her decision to misname the rules she's applying and use them in properly or whatever is really minor, but I do like seeing reactionaries being told in some way that their communities are harmful. Is it the best way? No, but it is a way. I believe that in a perfectly rational outlook, like utilitarian style, the good from that outweighs the bad. And that's my opinion, because everything we both think
okay, but if this were to be happening to a subreddit that you enjoyed, that you liked, you would be taking the totally opposite stance right now. And the fact that that doesn't bother you bothers me.
Yeah, no, I would still be upset, because I think that fat people hate is bad, and shit Reddit says is good. All of this is subjective.
But it's not, really.
Yeah,
we're talking about
that
objective
is bad, and that's subjective.
No, we're talking about objective things right here.
Why I'm going every time I argue on the internet, there's no such thing. Feels aren't like less than real. Feels
you don't think there's a difference between subjective or objective?
I don't believe that in an internet argument being conducted over Skype while you're streaming, either of us are going to be able to make a solid defining like difference between objective and subjective statements, unless we're directly quoting.
I think I can very easily do it. I think that I can say that I believe that it is objectively wrong to cut down rules to get rid of something you don't like. I think that that's an objective statement. That's not like a I feel thing. That's a statement that I wouldn't change. I wouldn't change that ruling for anything.
Correct. And I think it's objectively correct that cutting down rules that weren't being applied in the first place and can be changed with no warning, with no oversight, anytime the owner wants, doesn't mean shit, because they didn't mean anything. It's like trees that were already cut down. Whoa. What? Sure, in principle, but I don't operate principles, Steven. There are objective that, there you go, there's that word, considerations be made here, and one of which is the fact that while these rules may not have never really existed, because she can do whatever the fuck she wants, it's not the government. It's not like when you break a rule, they get to break it again because they have jurisprudence.
I don't think we're ever going to agree on that.
So the rules didn't exist, but the fat people haters did.
All right. Oh, okay.
Well, is that not objective? I think that's pretty close to objective. That the rules
no, that what you just made, that saying that it's okay to cut it down or whatever, that's an objective statement, but I disagree with it.
But you disagree with an objective statement? Doesn't that
yes.
mean you're like a fundy?
No, you can disagree with an objective statement. You can't really disagree with like a subjective statement, I don't think. That's like the difference between objective or subjective. Subjective would be like, I really don't like this song. And it's like, okay, well, I mean, I can't really say anything against it. Or subjective would be something like, I don't like fat people hate. Okay, I mean, I can't really disagree with you. Objective would be something like, I think it's okay to ban subreddits as long as they're like morally dubious and that's okay.
Wait, how is this a feels weird thing? If I say I hate fat people hate, that's objective because my feelings are objectively, like that's true. It's objectively true in a universal
Okay. The statement about your feelings is objectively true, but your feelings themselves are subjective. Do I really have to clarify that?
You can separate your feelings from your totally logical ethical considerations, dude. Come on, neither of us can do that. No one can do that.
I think you're like getting into like absurdism or something here.
No.
I think
we're
so.
We're both. What's this? There's like this fetishization of like logic.
Because logic is important. It's not like a pointless pseudo intellectual fetishing. Logic is important because it helps you keep conversations straight.
We're both pseudo intellectuals.
I don't really consider myself. I like to think I'm like a relatively reasonable, rational individual.
No, you can be both. You can be both. As far as I'm concerned, pseudo intellectuals, people who get into online arguments at 5 a.m. about subjects that can't be backed up with sources or cited. Like, come on. I understand we come from two different worlds, but most of the arguments that I'm used to making, like in classroom, this sounds so pretentious, I'm not even a fucking bachelor degree holder. But like, in there you kind of have to like cite shit, and it's like, oh cool, this is objectivity. Sure, we're fucking undergrads who have no idea what the fuck we're talking about, and we shit our diapers every time we go
we're
in
ta- we, you,
That's
we,
the intellectual we're ta- level we're working
no,
on.
No, I think that like, some of the things that we're talking on, I think like, do you think it is okay? Okay. Do you think it is okay for a website to remove content, even if it's breaking its own rules by doing so, if it's something that you disagree with, or if you think it's something that you think is bad? That's like an objective statement, like, yes, and then you can argue for or against that. I don't really think for like subjective statements, you can't like, you can explain why, but you can't like argue against them, right? To use like the fat people hate thing, right? If you say, I don't like fat people hate, that's a subjective statement. I can't like tell you you're wrong. You can't be wrong in an objective.
Like a song is good, but then you can argue that like in a constructive sense, it's really, I could say like, I like a song and you can't really argue that.
Exactly, there are differences in that. For instance, I could say like, oh, well, I like this song. Right? And it could be like a Jonas Brothers song, and you can't really tell me I'm wrong. Or I could make the statement of, this song is actually a really good song, right? Which is an objective statement, and you could attack that statement academically, right? Well, this isn't actually a good song, it's very simple, like, for different reasons, right? But you can't-
Yeah, I mean-
No, those are- what I just said are two true statements. There isn't a difference between being objective and subjective. You must know this.
Did you just say is or is not?
Is, there is.
There is, but it's blurry.
It's not blurry at all.
We're
can't
not,
really-
we're not
you
rational
can't-
creatures. We're not rational creatures, dude. For instance, if you can define good objectively, like in a Webster's dictionary applies to all people thing, that I would concede that point. I understand what you're saying. I agree that some statements can be defended and argued against, and some statements are so completely rooted in opinion that there's no point going either way. I agree. So let's move on.
Okay.
I think Nicki Minaj makes good music. No one seems to agree with me on that.
Okay, and I can argue against it because that's kind of an objective statement.
You totally could, but you couldn't argue against me saying Nicki Minaj is hot, because, I mean...
If you were to say something like, I like Nicki Minaj's music, I can't really argue against that, because that's a subjective statement.
Well, and it's true, because, I mean, it's... Can't
true or false is irrelevant. It's like, a subjective statement. When you say something like, I like Nicki Minaj's music, instead of this, okay, your like for that is subjective. Like, I can't tell you you're wrong.
So subjectivity in that sense is true, because it's like, you can't prove that wrong.
Sure. What?
You can't prove that I don't like something that I like. It's not something to be argued. I understand your point. Where's this heading?
I don't know what we're even talking about now. It's all over.
I think I don't know. I don't like the fetishization of lay logic and lay reason on the internet.
That's because you don't understand their purpose. They're very, very important.
Why do I have to not understand? I get logic and reason, dude.
Well, then why are you saying that it's a... Why do you think that it's a fetish to think that it's good to have a rational, reasonable conversation?
Because
maybe this is why I think
people who understand that we're flawed creatures and
that being a flawed creature doesn't mean anything. That has nothing to do with anything. So all of philosophy is a waste. No, it doesn't. So all of philosophy is wasted because we're flawed creatures and we'll never be perfect.
No. When did I say that?
Because that's what you're implying. When I try to say that I think that logic is important in a discussion, you just say, well, we're all imperfect creatures.
No, I agree that logic and reason are important discussions.
Then why are you making fun of it?
Do you think, like, feminists don't use computers? Do you think, like, I think it's a magic box? Come the fuck on. But, by the way, did you know that sociology is considered a hard science by one dude? I read that online. Anyway.
What? Wait, nobody considers sociology a hard science.
Huh?
No, nobody in science considers sociology a hard science. It's not.
I read that one guy did.
Okay, whoever he is, he doesn't work in science.
Well, neither do you, so fuck you, buddy. Anyway, who cares? Hard science.
Soft science versus hard science.
Is this really the... I was making a joke. Is this really gonna...
Oh, okay.
I don't think hard science is better than soft science.
I never said it was, but you can't call sociology or, like, psychology or economics.
I just said one guy did. Find that guy. Debate him on Skype. Anyway.
Okay.
What the fuck was I saying? No, I agree. Logic and reason important. Obviously, who would disagree with that? So this is part of what's that? The generosity principle. It's when you're making an argument. I learned the generosity principle in League. If you're full health and the enemy is half health and they start attacking you, be generous. Assume that they're not stupid. Assume you're about to be ganked. If I say something like the fetishization of logic and reason, be generous. I tie my shoes in the morning. Don't assume he doesn't.
Okay, so you're making the mistake of thinking that people are very easily capable of having rational discussions. They're not. There's a reason why things like logic are, like, so strictly studied, and why a lot of people bring it up in online discussions, because people don't.
No,
things like
no,
character assassination and ad hominem are very, very, very common.
Or, yeah, it's the opposite, though. I agree. It's super.
So if you agree with that, it seems weird that you would attack somebody for trying to uphold consistent logic.
I'm an atheist, but if I go into our atheism, I can, like, get mad at people for fetishizing atheism. I don't literally mean fetishize, you have a sexual, like,
I'm not, nobody even brought up sexual anything. I never said that.
Well, no, I'm just, that's what the fetish is. I don't mean that. What I do mean, however, is that I believe that people take it to this concept. It's like how people fetishize science.
Fetishize what?
Science good? Fucking yeah, I'm talking to you on an iPhone, okay? But some people like the idea of science to the point where they actually plot out discussion about it, because they have this sort of idealized view of it. Logic and reason, perfectly good. However, as you just said yourself, we have to concede that at the end of the day, we're just two apes screaming at each other over a Silicon Valley, and we can't... The actual, like, principles of rational debate are wasted on this discussion. We're both just... We've been interrupting each other, there's no timer.
Okay, you said some really dumb stuff in the past, and I don't really like you, and I think you're kind of dumb, so I think everything you're saying is wrong. Okay, so we're just gonna abandon all rationale. I'm just gonna say that every time you say something I disagree with, okay?
When did I say we should abandon all rationality?
You're saying that's the implication when you say that it's pointless!
Stop implying. Why not ask?
I'm not implying. That's exactly what you're saying.
You just said that's what it was implied. You literally just said that's what was implied. Then I said, then don't suggest I'm implying. And then you said that's what I said. Come the fuck on, dude. Be consistent. No.
What? People should be what? Consistency doesn't matter because we're not rational individuals anyway. So why should we care about consistency?
A rational individual would forget what I said 4 seconds after I said it.
Go buy yourself some hot chocolate.
Okay, Steven, yes, no question. You have to answer this yes, no. Okay, I'm dead. You have to answer this, okay? Do you seriously believe that I think that logic and reason are not, like, important or good things?
No, I think that you're jumping around a lot to prove, like, really weird arguments.
That's how I think you are, but that's
I think I've been, like, really well-grounded
and... And I think that I am, too. That's the thing. This is what I mean. Both of us feel like both of us are being rational. We don't really have an audience. I mean, we have your audience. We don't have a neutral audience. I'm not saying that they're all dumb or whatever, but there's obviously a bias. So the actual principles of, like, strict legitimate debate in which we can actually, like, factually ascertain...
I was never calling for any strict principles of strict debate. I just didn't want us to use, like, horrible, fallacious arguments that make the conversation pointless.
But you think you've been more rational than me, and I think you've been more rational than you. Both of those are subjective statements, and I'm saying there's no objective way to find out which one of us is being more rational, so we should drop it entirely, and we'll just both assume we're both being who we are, which is probably pseudo-intellectuals arguing on Skype. That's pretty sure that's what we are.
Okay.
Like, why do you say shit like that, dude? Why do you say, I think I've been pretty rational in these arguments, but you've just been jumping around? Who's gonna, what? I think the other way. Why even say that? Why? That's
because
like I think
because I like, because I feel like a lot of the things that you're saying are, like, really weirdly off, and you're playing, like, a lot of... I feel like when you start to argue with somebody and they're playing a lot of semantics games, I feel like their argument is really weak.
I don't feel like I've been playing semantics games.
When we started arguing about whether or not Fat People Hate should have been banned, and then whether or not you would do so, or how you would feel if somebody were to do it, versus I'm trying to play this and talk at the same time.
I believe that's nuance. It can get. Dude.
So the semantics. So now we've. It's more semantics.
Okay. What?
I don't know.
About semantics, like you actually fucking arguing that some people necessarily believe all men are rapists. Haven't we both been a little bit hyperbolic in this discussion? Is that not a form of semanticism? Semanticing over the top isn't really any better or worse than semanticing, like, around the issue, you know? Both of us can be accused legitimately of hyperbole in this discussion. I think it would be stupid of either of us to accuse the other one of being irrational in this discussion, because we have no objective mediator. We have no mediator. Do you think debate, like actual debates between people who study rap, do you think it happens in an empty room? You need more than two people, dude. So let's not even discuss it. Come on, fuck it.
Okay.
Right? That's a rational statement.
Sure.
We could get a mediator, but who the fuck's gonna be neutral on this subject? Who on the internet doesn't have an opinion that falls left or right of center for us?
I don't know. All right.
Okay, dude.
What?
I can see where this is going. I just got one question.
Yeah, what up?
What made you change your mind from being a libertarian to being slightly right of socialism?
This is like another, like, 10-hour fucking conversation.
No, because I agree with you on that. There's the disagreement's what takes forever. I'm just curious. Legitimate.
Different views are changed on different things. It would depend on what specific thing we're talking about.
I'm not baiting you, dude. I'm honestly curious. Just, I want to know. I used to have views that I disagree with. Now, I'm just curious. I'm asking in, like,
objectively
a non-argumentative way.
Which is a problem.
We can talk that way.
Objectively retarded people cannot understand that. This is level 5 autism.
We can.
A helmet. Bim's tiny.
No, there's a voice.
Yeah, sorry. I don't know. There's just something. It would depend on the topic. I don't want to go into all of this right now.
Oh my god.
That's too much, dude.
I was genuinely not sarcastically happy when I heard that.
I know, but it like me diving into this would be like a whole other huge.
I've been learning more about socialism lately. Econ has never been my, like, focus of study. I've always just loosely identified as left of center. But now that I know more about socialism, I found it really fascinating, and I wanted to know what your perspective was on it. I'm sure it's a subject that you've researched if you've changed your mind on it. That's the kind of person that you are.
Wow. tough?
I was just trying to hold out. You're not gonna answer that question.
Maybe another time.
Can we not argue over fucking Gamergate next time? I cannot believe that word was even.
Yeah, sure.
Enjoy your game. What champion are you playing?
I don't know. This guy don't seem to have one on the screen for 7 deaths this game.
And to conclude, the only existing official ratified medical opinion on the subject is that transgender people, after a certain amount of time, lose the physiological
capabilities. That's not a medical opinion. That's from, like, one person that's not, like... That's...
From a doctor.
Doesn't matter. That's not how science works. You can't say that. You can't claim that.
A
one
medical opinion
doesn't matter.
Is an opinion. I didn't say people.
Yeah, but a medical opinion from one person is literally worthless. Like, it might as well be tabloid. Yes,
it's a
yes.
Little bit more.
No, it's not. It's absolutely not at all. Not at all. It absolutely is not at all. I promise you, if you find anybody that goes to school doing any kind of hard science, that they will agree with me. Nobody would ever say
that. Pretension?
No, that's not pretension. I'll bet money. I'll bet money on it. However much you want to bet right now, I'll bet money on it.
I'd agree that one person isn't significant enough.
Not only is it not significant, it would never be brought up. It would never be brought up. It would never be brought up.
Dude, this is so... Dude, what... Okay, what would happen if you had found one person that said the opposite? You'd be playing this high and mighty peer review game.
Nope.
You'd be like, huh.
Nope. Nope. Go read one. I don't even do that. Go read the argument that I had on my subreddit, where some guy was arguing and he didn't provide a source for what he said. And then I argued back and I was like, yeah, but my source is kind of shaky, so I'm curious what you could find. I even said it on a source that I found. No, I would not ever cite one medical person saying one thing and saying, like, oh, well, look, so it looks like medical people think this, because only one medical person saying something is not...
So if it's worthless either way, why have you taken a stance on something that is only common sense on an issue that doesn't have any, like, medical consensus on it yet? Is your common sense worth more than the opinion of this one person? Common sense isn't worth much, you know.
Because it's not just like a common sense,
because
we're dealing...
Hand off the stove.
It's not a common sense. We know for a fact... You know for a fact that men have a physiological advantage over women. And you know for a fact that people transgendering or trans... What's the word I'm looking for?
No, just say that.
Converting? Transgendering from one... Transforming. Transitioning, fuck. We know that people transitioning from one gender to another are a certain gender before another gender, right? We know that. And that there is a degree...
They were always the same.
Oh, sex, what? You know exactly what I mean. You know exactly what I mean. We know that those things are true. So...
That's an important distinction.
Okay. So we know that those things are true. So I think that it's okay to have the position to say that...
But we can add a couple facts. We also know that extensive exposure to hormone therapy...
But we wouldn't say 100%. We don't know that. We don't know that it's 100%. And it does have to be a percentage of manliness remaining, and we know that... Being a man makes you intrinsically better at athletics than any part of that.
This is a very unscientific discussion.
This isn't unscientific at all. Being a man confers a great advantage on you athletically. That's not pseudo, that's not bullshit, that's an absolute fact.
Yeah, so being born with certain genetics. It's like that person
Yeah,
said.
Certain genetics, like being a man.
Dude, was this not like a sick as fuck point? Come on.
It wasn't a sick point, it was a really disingenuous point. Because it might make a woman read it and think like, oh, well, I'm born a woman, maybe I'll get the right genetic traits to make me, like, competitive in athletics. Do you ever remember what happened? There was a point where, What was it when, like, the best female...
That was so stupid.
No, that's stupid saying, some people are just genetically gifted, like, well, so, man is just one part of it. Remember what happened when, like, the best female, like, one of the best female tennis players in the world said, like, oh,
yeah,
I think I can take her, and she got fucking horribly. Like, I'll even use the word. It really was.
Dude.
It really was that bad.
No, it really wasn't. She's still one of the top tennis players in the world. She made a post.
One of
the...
Wasn't
What's
even close. Well, the point is to just say, like, oh, well, some people have some different genetic advantages. Like, the same as, like, being born a little bit quicker versus being a woman.
Yeah, after multiple years of therapy, that's the point. Alright, what was I saying?
Holy
flying dildos, just because a guy has a degree, his opinion is now fact, by that logic.
Transgender people?
Any person with a religious degree can claim God exists, and thus it must be fact. This guy just lost all validity in any argument he participates in. What a clown.
Enemy double. Why did I vote no? Okay. I love you. We'll talk again later, okay?
Good luck with your game, Steven.
All right. Thanks, buddy. I love you. Peace out.